Talk to me about Trevor Mallard. Now, I read your column overnight. You're quite exercised by this. He's copped it in the House, isn't he?
Well, this is the worst behaviour I've seen from a speaker in all my time here, and I've been here a long time, Heather. And that statement that he put out, in fact, about this time yesterday, he said that he accepted that his understanding of the definition of rape at the time was incorrect. Well, I'm sorry. I've got a piece of paper in front of me that shows that Trevor Mallard knew exactly what rape was about, and I quote him. This is from November the 16th, 2010. He said, "I can remember going back to some of my earlier experiences in legislation, even as far back as the 1980s, the courts and making decisions on particular cases going to what the extent of Parliament was, what it was essentially looking at." Mm. He said, "I think the particular case he can remember was a Court of Appeal case that flowed from the rape law reform legislation." And then he went on to describe what this rape law reform legislation was about.
Yeah.
So to use the excuse he knew nothing about, he knew little about what the offence of rape incurred was stretching the point. Parliament was kicked off this afternoon by a National Shadow House leader, Chris Bishop, who wanted a myriad of questions answered by the Speaker about the man he wrongly accused of being a rapist last year. He was followed by Acts David Seymour, and as you'll hear, both men were slapped down by...
If you were intending to make a statement to Parliament about... reports in the media that you have apologised to someone for comments made by you as Speaker last year?
The answer to that is no, and the second part of the answer is part of the agreement is that I make no further comment.
I think the House would like an explanation, and I urge you to reconsider, because there are a range of matters that people would like to understand. You hold yourself out as a speaker who campaigns against bullying and harassment.
Member will resume his seat.
Yeah, can I just say, you know, David Seymour is right. Trevor Mallard is trying to pitch himself here as somebody who will stop bullying and harassment. Will you tell me what is more bullying than someone losing their job over something they haven't done?
Yeah, well, exactly. And just to correct you earlier, Heather, this man lost his job several months ago, so he's been without work that long. But look, as the House was being wound up for the year with the adjournment debate, David Seymour was on his feet again and finished what usually is a light-hearted wind-up speech by winding the Speaker up again.
I'm afraid to say that, in my view, the choices you've made over the last 24 hours have diminished that character further than even I could have imagined. And the simple answer is, if you feel unable to explain those events to the House, then maybe you should not take the position, or maybe your colleagues on the other side of the House should take it from you. But so much for you. Merry Christmas.
Order. The member's time has expired in more ways than one.
Oh, he can say the same for himself. Can you recall, in any of your time in Parliament, Barry, a speaker under a cloud like this one is?
I can never recall it. And to manipulate the media the way the Speaker did yesterday is reprehensible. He now knows Parliament is adjourned for the year, so it's in recess now until February the 9th next year. He knows there'll be no more questions of his behaviour. He knows we can't search parliamentary services under the Official Information Act. Mm. So if we really wanted to know how much was involved in this defamation suit, how much money was paid out, how much his legal bills are, we'll never know.
Yeah, because the fact is, we have probably paid for it, the taxpayers.
Oh, no, we most definitely have paid for it, but the Speaker's non-accountable to anyone but himself, and that's a disgrace. Although there is a committee that meets next year, it's not the Business House Committee, but it's another committee in Parliament, and certainly his behaviour in this will be examined by that.
See, the thing is, I can sort of anticipate he's already had a hard time from the National Party in the last term, right, for being biased, and even senior members of the press gallery have said, yep, absolutely, he is biased. Now he's got this against him. He's going to have a really hard time keeping this House in order.
No, he most certainly will. And you know what, Heather? If he'd made this apology last year, and he could have done that because he knew he was in the wrong, clearly, he could have done that last year, but if he'd done it, then it was a Labour-led government, including New Zealand First.
Yes.
New Zealand First would have voted him out of office. There would have been a motion of no confidence in him. He would be gone by now, and he knows that. That's why the timing of this was, to me, quite despicable.